Good morning students. So in today's session we are going to start data handlings using pandas part 2. So here we will discuss some terms related to our statistics. So all of you must know about better descriptive statistics. So it is used to analysis the data so that we will have the summarized data, meaningful data. So Python pandas have some of the features to perform this descriptive statistics analysis on our data. For example, Betty, this one is our data frame. We already know that how to create our data frame using dictionary with list. Okay, so suppose we have to create this data frame. So already I have given you the Python code. So here, which method have been used? The method which we are using here is dictionary using list. Okay, so what are the different descriptive statistics available in Python pandas that can be performed on our data frame? Arbitrary, the terms are already known to you. This is sum function, which will give you the sum of particular column and row. Then we are having mean function, which will give you the arithmetic mean, or you may also call it as average. Then median, which will give you the middle value from a set of values. Then describe, I will show you directly in the Python code. Then count, it will count the number of non-any values. Non-any values means, betty, any means the values which are not available. So when we will perform count operation, only those values will be counted which are available. So empty value will not be included in our counting. Then mean function, it will return you, it will give you the minimum value from the set of values. Then max value, it will give you the maximum value from set of values. And then variance will give you, this function var will give you variance from set of values. Then std function will give you the standard deviation from a set of values. Then quantile, betty, what is quantile? Quantile divides the set of values in different quarters. Means what will be the 25% of this data, what will be the 50% of that data, what will be the 75% of data. All these things are known as quantile. Okay, so first 25% is known as first quartile. Then the cumulative 25%, that is 50%, is known as second quartile. Then 75% is known as third quartile. So these are some of the descriptive statistics that can be calculated in Python pandas also, bete. So we are going to discuss this only. So I can tell you what are the three different ways in which these functions can be used. Okay, so these functions can be used on the whole data frame, the first thing. Then the second way is these functions can be used column wise, and these functions can be used row wise. Okay, so let me tell you first about how these functions can be used in the on the whole data frame. Suppose some function I have written only df, means I have written name of the data frame. It means that the sum function will be operated on the whole data frame. And how it will be performed? It will be performed column wise. Let us check. Now see, bete, sum function has been performed column wise. For name, all the name has been added. Added means combined. Age, all the values have been added. Then, sorry bete, let me run first this one. Then we will perform this one. Now see, all the names has been added, then all the ages has been added, then pre-test scores values have been added, then post-test score values have been added. Okay, so column wise addition has been done. If you want row wise addition to be performed, you have to mention axis is equal to 1. That means it will perform the sum row wise. Okay, so what we are having, we are having the addition of the first row, that will give you 71. What if you want to perform sum of any particular column? In that case, bete, you have to mention for which column you want the sum. Suppose we want the sum for the column age, then you have to mention here age in the descriptive of data frame. So it will give you only the sum of which column? The column age. Sorry. Now see, we will have the sum for the column age only. Okay, so all the functions can be performed on three different ways. But first, if you want to perform it on any particular column, in that case you have to mention the name of the column. If you want to perform the function on the whole data frame column wise, then you have to write x is equal to 0, or by default it will perform column wise. And if you want it to be performed the row wise, then you have to mention x is equal to 1. Let me show you another function. Bete, suppose if you want to perform max, okay, what will be the result? Let us check. It will give you the maximum value. Okay, so let us see. Maximum value for name is Tina. How it is calculated? But now it will check the what? Alphabetical order. Okay, so since we are getting T in alphabetically order, we will get T at the last among these ones. So the maximum value is Tina. If you will write minimum, which will be the minimum value? But it will be Amy, since A comes first. Okay, so the maximum value for age is 73, maximum value of pre-test score is 31, and maximum value for post-test score is 94. Similarly, you can check for mean, median, mode, everything. Okay, so what if we will write here x is equal to 1? Let us check. This time, but name will be calculated, name will be discarded, because the numbers cannot be compared with the string object. So only comparison will be these three on these three values. Okay, so let us check the result. Now see, we are having age equal to maximum value among these three is 42. Maximum value among these three is 94. So automatically, bete, this string value will be discarded. So similarly, we can check all these three, all the descriptive statistics functions available in data frame. And okay, describe function. What it will do, bete? It will give you all the descriptive statistics at once. Suppose I am writing here df dot describe, then it will give you all the mean, median, mode, variance, standard deviation, all those things. Now you can see what you are getting when you are using describe function. Okay, so that was all about bete descriptive statistics. I hope you all have understood. So thank you for watching.